Despite 400 years of the marginalization of our Black bodies within the United States, we continue to soar. Black bodies have been tortured, policed in political and social spaces. Even the creative world has not been immune to the racism. In the world of high dance forms like ballet and theater, Black dancers and choreographers have had to challenge dogma that privileged white bodies are naturally more beautiful and graceful, while denying such attributes to Black bodies.
That's why one of the reasons why I wanted to do this is because nobody knows of you, of Lewis, of Arthur Mitchell.
But we don't tell our own stories. We don't tell people who we are.
My journey as a dancer choreographer began when I saw my first Broadway show. There, I became inspired. Inspired by the movement and the costumes, but more so by seeing performers on the stage who looked like me. I had the opportunity of performing in that show at the age of 16. I went on to learn and work with some talented individuals. I realized that my career would not have been possible if it weren't for those before me. I stand here because of them. I'm looking back at all of those individuals who inspired me and finding out that they too were inspired by someone, and that someone is Lewis Johnson.
His efficiency and then artistry, all of that at the same time was so unlike anybody I had ever met.
He could picture the clothes, the music. He was the camera. He had the whole picture.
Oh, he moved like quicksilver. So beautiful.
Because he's like a bouncing ball, you know. He's a compact body that can leap and jump, and he was fantastic.
To see Lewis attack the air, to see him become one with space, to see him, I'm gonna cry, to see him fly was just breathtaking.
Lewis always had this wonderful sense of ballet. You know, he always had that. He was blessed with two amazing abilities. One, athletics, and two, a classic line without even working on it. Mm. You know, you don't, the kind of things that Lewis' body just did, people work all their life to accomplish, you know.
Who is Lewis Johnson? He was the forefront of dance, carving out the route for other Black dancers. And I'm sure during his journey, he encountered many obstacles.
And you couldn't be in classes with other people. You had to find your own way of getting classes. You were not allowed in a class.
Not allowed.
Well, he said if you want to change the color of your skin and make yourself lighter.
I have friends that I've had for years that will say strange things to me, like, I just don't think that Black people belong in classical ballet, and never have and never will.
I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land.
We see that same segregation in the arts from TV, motion pictures, even here on the Great White Way. Let me ask you a question. How many people of color do you see when you go to a Broadway show?
Freedom, freedom, I can't move. Freedom, cut me loose. Yeah. Freedom, freedom, where are you? Cause I need freedom too. I break chains all by myself. Won't let my freedom rot in hell. Hey, I'ma keep on running cause the winner don't quit on themselves.
Yet, Lewis Johnson's powerful spirit overcame the many obstacles that were placed before him. I remember the first time I saw the epic Master the Wiz movie. It was amazing.
It was unlike any movie that ever been that had so many people of color.
Yeah.
Totally unlike any. Yeah. And it was brilliant choreography that he did. I mean, he thought that through and it was incredible.
Everybody look around, cause there's a reason to rejoice, you see.
Lewis belongs to a world that you don't even really see anymore. The,
right.
The dedication that the people had to their art and so forth was just, you could only aspire to it. Only aspire.
I've been very blessed to have done the things that I've done and been able to do. Being a dancer, choreographer, and I enjoy doing them.
You've worked with the best. Some wonderful people, right? Wonderful talent.
Oh, yeah.
What would you say to the young choreographers coming up today and young dancers? What kind of encouraging words would you give them?
Keep on going.